So today we have with us Dr. Raghav Gupta. He has scored rank 11 this year in INICET 2020. So many congratulations, Raghav. How do you feel?
I feel amazing. I have dreamt about this day since the start of this year. So it's like a dream come true for me.
You were expecting this rank?
No, not really.
Not really? So, what was your mindset when you came out of the exam?
Ma'am, when I came out of the exam, I was pretty satisfied that I have done well. But when I saw the solutions, then I thought that no, I'm not getting a very good rank. So at that time, I knew that maybe I've made mistakes. So basically, when the multiple correct questions, they were very confusing. The options were so close. So I felt that I did a lot of mistakes in those questions.
So according to you, the exam was on the difficult side, right?
Difficult, yes, ma'am.
But still, you have managed to score double-digit rank, and that is so close. And really super, super proud of you. So I'm sure everybody wants to know your strategy. Like, everybody knows that the INICET update, your edition, was very near to the exam, like 1.5 months just before the exam. So did you change your strategy then? Like, you have given the AIIMS exam, also the NEET exam, and you scored really well in those exams also. And suddenly the pattern was changed. So how your preparation changed according to that?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, there was not much change in my preparation because like everyone said that AIIMS is conducting the exam. So we were thinking that AIIMS will ask the sort of questions that it generally asks. So I was anyway preparing for AIIMS. So there was not much change in my preparation. I knew I had to prepare the past year topics of AIIMS only. I thought that I'll give some more time to JIPMER topics, past year questions. And PGI also I had done throughout my year, past year questions of PGI. So I don't think there was much change in my preparation after the INI was announced.
Okay. So you started your preparation in which year?
Ma'am, this year only, from January.
January only, like you are doing any of the studying material, like standard textbook, you must be preparing for like in third year or fourth year? No.
No, ma'am. I haven't read any standard textbook, which is not a good thing, but I wasn't studious at that time. So I just attended the classes and I had prepared notes, but I haven't read them. I had just collected material that would help me in this year. I had that material, but I hadn't read anything by then.
So till Jan, you prepared all your notes and you haven't started as of now. Like in Jan, you actually started with your preparation. So
yes.
If like anybody who is attempting the exam, so if you have to give them the like the daily routine, what you have to follow on daily basis, what was your like daily routine? Were you solving the Q banks or the videos? What was the dissection of that?
Yes, ma'am. So ma'am, I like from in the initial part of the year, I had my focus was to read all the theory, all the notes which I had made, and give the test and discussion simultaneously after completing each subject. So at that time, my focus was not on videos. I basically it was reading the notes that I had prepared, and later part, like I when I had gone through with all the theory, I watched videos for about 4 to 5 hours per day. Those videos would consist of either past year videos or some update videos, like or some snapshot videos of the if I want to go through the image based part. So I would think, analyze that what I need for that. But about 4 to 5 hours each day, I would watch videos. In the morning, I would want to read the volatile topics because I'm fresh at that time. And at the night time, I would want to attempt some tests, maybe the test and discussion or the past year MCQs. So that was my routine.
Okay. So we were talking about the INICET exam. Did you give our prep ladders INICET exam this year?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, actually, I gave the INICET exams of prep ladder in the last week before the INI. So I found them very helpful. I basically wanted to be in that exam mode before the actual exam. So they really helped me increase my speed of solving MCQs. And I analyzed in what questions I was losing more marks, like the if like we didn't know the patterns, so I prepared for all the patterns, like it could be true, false or anything. So I was preparing for multiple possibilities that could that we could get in the exam. So and the basically this grand test doing these grand tests before the exam that helped that played a big part in getting this rank.
Right. So Raghav, actually everybody's preparation, like they all watch videos and they write notes, but the actual preparation is tested when you attempt the QBanks, right? So in Preplatter QBank, we have like various options like custom module, we have treasures, we have tags. So how you have utilized, and if somebody who is watching your video wants to know that, what tips you will advise them to attempt a QBank, what to follow that?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, in QBank, my focus was on practicing more of the past year questions, because Preplatter has all the questions of all the central exams, and I found them very helpful. So my basic focus was to practice all those questions, and the custom module also that gives us that option that we could keep the tag of the past year questions, the repeated questions, and we could then solve that custom module. So I utilized it in this way.
Okay. Were there any repeats in the exam this time?
Ma'am, there were repeats, many repeats from the AIIMS. Like direct repeats were around, I think maybe 15-20, and a lot of topics were repeated. But the thing is that they had put a lot of confusing options from their topics, so it was very difficult to crack those questions, even though the topics were repeats.
Okay, so if you have to decide, like the subject weightage, was it close to PGI or JIPMER or AIIMS? Like if you have to talk about the subject weightage.
Ma'am, the subject weightage was like I didn't find it identical to any of these. It was very strange this time, because the subjects which are like PSM was close to PGI, because in PSM there were very few questions, 5 or 6 questions, and like PGI asked less questions from PSM. So in that way, but in like obs and gyne has a lot of weightage in all these three exams, but in this particular exam it was very less, like around 8 or 9 questions only, and we expect generally 20 questions from obs and gyne. So and medicine was given a lot of weightage, pathology, microbiology, pharma, these had a lot of weightage, and the short subjects had a lot of weightage again, psychiatry and anesthesia again they had. So maybe the Nibhayan's part is played.
Yeah, this was the different part, like short subjects are not given much weightage, but this time all the subjects were asked in equal manner and everybody contributed some part in the exam, right?
Yeah.
So like you have been into Prepladders, like we have you have used Prepladder in your preparation. So if who was your favorite teacher, if I have to ask you that?
So naming a few teachers is, I really think it is unfair for the rest, because all the faculty is amazing. But then anyway, my personal favorites are Dr. Rajesh Kaushal and Dr. Deepak Marwa.
Okay, that's really nice. And Raghav, I'm sure like you have scored such a great rank, and despite scoring so well in the AIIMS exams already, you again attempted the ANI CET exam, and it can be a demotivating factor for most of the students, but you have come up with flying colors. So if you have to give any piece of advice or any piece of information to the students who will be the future aspirants for ANI CET or next exam, what will be that?
Ma'am, my advice will be to always think that you are the best and you will work like the best. And you have always have to think about your dream all the time, what you want to achieve, where you want to do your PG from, and what branch you want to do your PG. And if you keep thinking about this, you will work towards your dream. And you never have to give up, and you always have to believe that you can do better. And like for a NEET exam, we have 4 months now, and 4 months is a lot of time. So it doesn't matter what rank you got in this INI, you can do anything in these 4 months. So people should always believe in themselves, and they should never give up.
Right. So thank you so much, Raghav, for your valuable advice, and many, many congratulations from my end. You are a perfect example for all those students who have less time to prepare, but you have done such a great, smart work in your preparation. I'm sure everybody will be looking up to you.
Thanks a lot, ma'am.
Good wishes from my end. Take care. Bye.
Take care. Bye.